It is the DCS, and then I'm taking.
Yes.
This one's, sorry, it's specifically focused to the things that we.
Yeah, but, I mean, how can you understand? So, you can't understand the stuff we're talking about unless you understand how to make Lewis structures, for example.
Yeah.
So, there's not going to be questions specifically about Lewis structures that aren't tied to these chapters, but you're not going to be able to answer them.
So, if we want to do like a study based off the ACS online, they have some past exams. What would be the best way to do it? Because it sounds like it's very specific.
They don't have ACS past. They have ACS, I mean, I haven't seen them. You see them, and you can afford them to be, that's great, afford them. But all I've seen in the past or online is what we call the Chemistry Olympiad, which are high school exams.
Okay.
And they're fine, they're interesting stuff. Some of the questions are a little outlandish, you know, they're kind of like that. Amazing chemistry facts, sort of things. Sometimes the questions are a little off. But that might help you. We have the standardized, sorry, we have the Gen Chem prep in the library. In fact, I do have some exams that are full year exams, 105 and 106. So if you're interested in taking that for the final, you could take that for the final. But usually, my experience has been that, now, this would be a shorter term, but the specifics of Chem 105 are kind of forgotten for a little bit. For somebody who's returning a long time ago to take 106, kind of important that the exam focuses more on the specifics of this class. So that's why we use second term exams. Now, what was your past? Did you just take 106 as well?
I took 105.
All right. So, any other questions? Exams, final exams, practice problems, honesty. Where's the honesty? There it is. You're only hurting yourself with this rambunctious behavior, right? Cheating cheats yourself. True. Okay. Time to talk about chemistry. Right? Right. Okay. So then, ready for the question? What determines whether a compound is a solid, liquid, or gas at room temperature? What determines that? Huh? Temperature? Didn't I just say it at a given temperature? Okay. So what determines whether something's a solid, liquid, or gas at a given temperature? You can convert something from a solid or a gas by changing the temperature.
Pressure.
At a given temperature and pressure. Yeah?
Could be depending on the bonds that they're having.
The bonds that are in them. Okay. So the nature of the compound definitely determines whether it's a solid, liquid, or gas at a given temperature. Yeah? Specific heat. Something else, right? is either a liquid or a solid. Okay? Liquid or solid. So, I heard somebody say something about the movement of the molecules, which is worth discussing. What is called, what is the definition of the temperature of the system? That's right, the collective kinetic energy, right? So if I have two systems, this is not working out. These wonderful, wonderful pens are refillable, but who's going to refill it? Okay, two systems, both at 25 degrees Celsius. This one is C8H18, this one is CH4. Which one of these has greater kinetic energy? That's a plug. Why do you need a plug? This is a gas. CH18 is a liquid. Which one has greater kinetic energy?
Right.
Talk to your neighbor. Tell your neighbor. You've got to have a neighbor in this class. If you don't have a neighbor, you've got to go close to somebody that's a neighbor. Where did your chips? So you got to buy things. Okay. Everybody's got a neighbor? Which of those systems, the one on the left or the one on the right, has the greatest kinetic energy? And then you've got to explain to your neighbor. Okay. What's the answer?
They're the same.
They're the same. They're the same. Because the kinetic energy is related to?
The temperature.
Same temperature. Same kinetic energy. You guys remember the equation for kinetic energy?
1/2 mv.
1/2 mv². So the 1/2 mv² for the one system is, so we'll label these systems 1 and 2, right? So the mass of one, the velocity of the first system, mass of the molecules in the second system, the velocity of the molecules in the second system, right? Whose molecules are moving faster? One or two?
Two.
Okay, how do we know that? Faster this way than that. Can you figure that out? Anybody get a value for this? 2.67? Okay, so that means the lighter one is moving 2.6 times faster than the heavier one. Where did we put this into the equation? We didn't need to, right? We just know that they have the same kinetic energy, right? One thing that's less than obvious about this step, which is make sure you're aware of, is that if I have V2 squared, for example, or V1 squared, that's equal to V2 over V1 squared. Okay? This little math is it that I have to be aware of. Okay, so it's the intermolecular. Now, what does intermolecular mean? As opposed to, let's say, intramolecular?
Between.
Okay. Between molecules as opposed to within molecules. So, for example, here is a water molecule, right? This interaction between this oxygen and hydrogen, we call a what? Intramolecular. And it's a bond, right? A bond. The interaction between two water molecules would be intermolecular interaction. Right? And it's these interactions, the strength of those interactions, that determines whether a compound is a solid, liquid, or gas. If this is strong, then the compound is more likely to be what? Or it's a solid or a liquid, right? If it's weak, then it's going to be a gas. Okay? So, what determines whether the intermolecular interactions are strong or weak? Well, for water, the reason why water has such a high boiling point, and it is high, right? 100 degrees Celsius is relatively high in the world of small molecules, okay? The reason why it has such a high boiling point is because this is a strong intermolecular interaction. And the reason it's strong is because of the polarity of the bonds within the molecule. Now, do you guys remember what polarity means? Right? So I draw a bond, and you tell me if the bond is polar or not, right? Or maybe not if it's polar or not, but where the polarity lies, for example, right? So, can you, with your neighbor, identify whether these bonds, or which one of these bonds is the most polar, which side the polarity lies to, right? Can you do that?